So I request all of you to keep the cell phones horizontally for the maximum visibility. Okay, so let us understand what do you mean by encoding. So please note, whenever we do the data communication, whenever we need to send the data or a message through a communication channel, so we need to encode it in binary. For example, we have a code called as ASCII code. Whatever the message, whatever we have, so that will be encoded in ASCII of 8 bits, a unique code for each characters, and this will be sent in the computers for the communication purpose. So in general, character or text encoding is very much essential in data communication. Now, suppose we need to encode a text that comprises of some characters, let us say n characters alphabet. Say we have the problem of sending the data where data is formed by using n character alphabet. For example, if you consider English characters, 26 characters. So any paragraph, it is made up of 26 characters. If you consider uppercase and smaller case letters separately, then it is 52 characters set it is. So English character means, English one paragraph means it is made up of 26 plus 26 characters. Okay. So suppose if you want to encode a message consisting of say 52 characters, what is that optimal code that we can have? That is what we are discussing today. Okay. So encode by assigning each text character some sequence of bits called as code word. So what we do is some A, B, C, D or 0, 1, 2, 3. We take some code words and we encode it and we send it. So this is what usually done in all the data communication in the computer network. Okay. Now, what are the different types of encoding we have? The different types of encoding, two major types of encodings are, one is fixed length encoding, another one is variable length encoding. So what do you mean by fixed length encoding and what do you mean by variable length encoding? So let us understand these two terminologies. Consider we have a message called as ADDD. This is one message I need to communicate to somebody else. Okay. Say the character set is nothing but ABCD. We are considering only 4 characters as a set. Among that, we have chosen here in our message ADDD. That's all. 2 characters are used here. That's fine. Now, suppose use fixed length and variable length encoding. So let us consider fixed length encoding. The second example talks about the fixed length encoding. In the fixed length encoding, what we do is for A, B, C, D, we assign a binary code of fixed length. For example, A, B, C, D, there are 4 characters. So a 2-bit length binary code is used here. 2-bit length binary code is used. Actually, 2-bit length is sufficient for ABCD. Suppose ABCDE, then if there are 5 characters, I need to use a 3-bit length code. Of course, our observation here is these ABCD are encoded with fixed length of 2. Similarly, the another way is to encode ABCD is for A, let us give 000. For B, let us give 001. For C, let us give 01. For D, let us give 1. So this is variable length encoding. Now, if you consider the variable length encoding, suppose if you want to code Suppose if you want to code this ADDD, it is written as A is nothing but 000, B is nothing but 1, D is nothing but again 1, D is nothing but again 1. So 000111, it stands for this by using the variable length coding. Similarly, ADDD can be written as in the fixed length coding, it as 00, 11, 11, and 11. So ADDD is encoded as 00, 11, 11, 11. So these are the two ways in which we can do the fixed length coding as well as the variable length coding. Moving on, going in detail of the fixed length coding. So fixed length coding, each character takes say m bits. In fixed length coding, each character in our message takes m bit. For example, ASCII code, the each character it takes say 8 bit length. Okay. Now, what is the drawback of fixed length coding? The drawback of the fixed length coding is that whatever the message we are need to communicate, once we encode, the length of the binary bits will be too large. Unnecessarily, it will be too large. For example, if you have only ABCD, suppose if you are using 8 bit length for each characters, that much length is not required actually. Only 2 bit length is sufficient for ABCD by considering only ABCD. Okay, so 8 bit length may not be required. So that is a drawback of the fixed length coding. Now the question is how to overcome this particular drawback. How to overcome this particular drawback? So what we can do is, one alternate method we can use is nothing but variable length coding. So what we do in variable length coding is, whatever the characters that repeats frequently, whatever the characters that repeat frequently, shorter length code is assigned to that. Whatever the characters that doesn't repeat frequently, less frequently if it is repeating, give a longer length. Or in other words, suppose if you are using, suppose if you are, say our message consisting of say A, say A is repeating 50%, A is repeating say 50%, and say B is repeating say only 10%, B is repeating 10%. In that case, for A, assign a coding with smaller length. For B, let us assign a length with greater length. So this is the idea behind this variable length encoding. Now the question is, there are two ways in which we can achieve the variable length encoding. One is, one technique that is nothing but the prefixed code. What is that prefixed code that is used for variable length coding? For example, suppose if you have ADDD, it is coded as, say #000, #01, #01, #01. Prefix hash is used to denote beginning of the each letter. Beginning of A is denoted by hash. Beginning of D is denoted by hash. So hash is a prefix symbol used. This is the complete message, prefixed message it is. Another thing is, without using prefixing also we can code it. So that is what most popular actually. So it is nothing but prefix free code. This is called as prefix free code, where 000 represents A, 1 represent D, 1 represent D, again 1 represent D. Okay, so prefix free codes are mostly preferred. And the question is, how we can design this particular codes? Okay. So let us understand how we can design these type of codes. To design this variable length coding, prefix free variable length coding, we can use something called as a binary tree. Okay, so variable length coding can be achieved through the tree problem, binary tree problem. So how we can achieve through binary tree? So let us say I have three characters, say A, B and C. So let us construct a binary tree, something like this. This is one possible tree. So So let us assign zeros and ones to both left and right. Now, at the leaf nodes, we are writing this ABs. Three leaf nodes, because I need ABC. Only ABC is the characters I'm using. So three leaf nodes I require. That is why I have this particular design. So what this represents is, A can be represented as 0, 0. It is nothing but the path from the labels of the path from root to this particular leaf node. A is coded as 0, 0. So length, it is nothing but the labels used for the path. Similarly, B is nothing but 0, 1. It is 0, 1. C is nothing but 1. So this is one coding that we can achieve. This is one variable length coding for ABC. I'm considering only the alphabet set as ABC one. Is it only the one possibility? Definitely not. Several other possibilities we have. One other possibility is this one. The tree is constructed something like this, and it is assigned with the labels 0, 1, 0, 1, and A is encoded as 0, B is encoded as 1, 0, C is encoded as 1, 1. Now the question is, several such possibilities we have for construction of such trees. Now, how to find an optimal binary tree that is the challenge for us. What do you mean by optimal here? We want to design such a binary tree. We want to design such a binary tree that gives minimal length for the message. This is what optimal means. Optimal binary tree means the binary tree that gives the minimal length for the message. So how to construct such a binary tree? So I repeat, the whole problem of Huffman coding, the problem statement is, design a optimal binary search tree that gives the minimal variable length coding for a message. So this is the problem statement. So given us the character set, so for construction of such trees, what is required for us? We need the character set. Character set in our case here, it is ABC. And we also need, what is the frequency? Frequency means how much times it repeats. Say 0.5, 0.4, say 0.1. It is nothing but the probability that it is repeats. So given the frequencies of the character occurrences, then we can construct such a optimal binary search tree. So that tree will find out the shorter encoding for the high frequency characters and longer encoding for the low frequency characters. So such a problem, finding out such a binary tree, is called as optimal tree problem. Now, one solution for this optimal tree problem is designed by David Huffman, who is a North American computer scientist. So he found one greedy algorithm for this particular case. The method is popularly known as Huffman coding. Let us understand how this Huffman coding works. It's a very, very simple algorithm. Let us illustrate with an example. Say it is given to us now. We need to have a message of symbol set. Alphabet set is nothing but A, B, C, D, and underscore. A, B, C, D, and underscore. Five letters we have. Five characters we have. And its frequency is given. Frequency means it is the probability of appearance. Probability of appearance means, suppose if you construct the message consisting of, let us say 100 characters. In that 100 characters, 35 characters will be A. In that 100 characters, 10 characters will be B. 20 characters will be C. 20 characters will be D, 15 characters will be underscore. So frequency is nothing but the probability of appearing this particular character in the message. So we now got to know that A is repeating, it is having the highest frequency, and B is having the lowest frequency. So our aim now is to design a method, design a binary tree that gives a coding such a way that for A, we should get the minimal length, and for B, we should get the maximum length. Okay. So let us try to construct the tree, binary search, binary tree. So what we have to do is, initially, let us take something like this. Let us sort it. Of course, sorting may not be required, but again, we can sort it. 0.1, 0.15, 0.2, 0.2, 0.35. So these are the five letters that is given, and it's with its probability. Now what we have to do is, from this particular the given information, two nodes we need to merge together. Two means which two we need to take. Which two we need to take, it is nothing but okay, sorry. Yeah, so let us take B as well as underscore. B and underscore are having the smaller frequencies. B and underscore is having the smaller frequencies. Sorry. B and underscore having the smaller frequencies. The frequencies are nothing but 0.1 and 0.15. Now merge them together. Merge them together. Sorry for the okay. So 0.1 stands for B, 0.15 stands for underscore. These are the smallest frequencies that are available here. These smallest frequencies you need to combine to form a tree, something like this. Okay. Combine 0.1 and 0.15. If you add, you will get 0.25. This is 0.25. So in first iteration, what we'll get is merge these two and get this one. Okay. So hope you understood how to merge it. So B and C, and form a root node with the combined probabilities. 0.1 plus 0.15, it is 0.25. Now remaining we have C, D and A. C, D and A. Again sort them together. Sort them as per the frequencies. Of course, sorting may not be required. Only thing is that we need to select the two smallest frequencies. That's all. Two smallest frequencies you have to select from the rest. So we have four probabilities as of now, four frequencies, 0.2, 0.2, 0.25, 0.35. So we have altogether four. Let us take least two frequencies, 0.2 and 0.2. Again, combine them together. So combine them together, it will give you this particular tree. 0.2, 0.2, C and D. So merged together will give you 0.4. So now you will get, now we are having three frequencies here, 0.25, 0.35, 0.4. Again, combine two minimum frequencies. Combining minimum two frequencies. So what we'll get? Combining minimum two frequencies, that is nothing but 0.25 as well as 0.35. So combining them, it will give you 0.6. So look, see how it is merged together. 0.25, 0.35, it is merged to form this particular tree. with the combined probability 0.6. Finally, we are ending up with two nodes only, 0.4 as well as 0.6. Again, combine them to get the final tree. So we got the final tree, something like this. This is 0.1. Oh, sorry, this is 1. Of course, this is 0.4 and 0.6. So this is the final tree we are getting. So once you get the final tree, final binary tree, next, for each node, left and right childs, you need to label. So label them, both the branches as 0, 1. Similarly, 0, 1. 0, 1. 0, 1. For every label, you have to label it as 0, 1. 0, 1. 0, 1. 0, 1. If you make it as 1010, 10, that also doesn't make any difference. The length of the code will be same. The coding letters will be different. For letters convenience, for our convenience, let us keep this as 01 always. 0101. Now, what is the code for each symbols? The code for each symbols are nothing but, for C, the code is nothing but 00. For D, the code is nothing but 01. For B, the code is nothing but 100. For underscore, the code is 101. The code for A is 11. So the code for A is 11. So the result is given here. So please observe this. The code for A is 11. Code for B is 100. Code for C is 00. Code for D is 00. Code for underscore, it is 101. You can observe one thing here. For A is having the highest frequency, got a code with length 2. Code B is having the lesser frequency, got the code with length 3. So highest frequency got the lowest length code, and less frequency symbol got the highest length code. So this is what Huffman coding is. So once the coding is done, encoding is done for all the symbols. Now, any message is given means you can encode now. For example, DAD can be encoded as, DAD can be encoded as, for D it is 01, A it is 11, D it is 01. 01 11 01 01 11 01. This is how DAD is encoded. Okay, now you can decode also. Suppose some code is given to you. Let us say the code given is something like this. How we can decode this? What you have to do is you have to scan from the left to right. Say 1101, C for that. C for 1101. 1111, it is available. 11 is available here. So 11 is for, it is A. So the first letter is A. So this stands for A. Okay. Then go with the next characters. Next character 0110. 011. Go for scanning it. 0001 we have. So 01 is available here. Okay. So for this one, you assign 01. 01 is nothing but D. Next, go for go for searching 1011. 101. 101 is matching here. It is stands for underscore. 101 stands for underscore. Then I have 1101. 1101. 11 is again A it is. 11 is again A. Finally, 01. It is nothing but D. So altogether, it is nothing but AD underscore DAD. AD underscore DAD. So this is how we can decode. So special prefix is not required for us. Just by scanning the code words, we can get the original message back. So this is how it works. So the algorithm can be stated as follows. Two steps. So initialize the n node trees now initially. Then record its frequencies. That is very much required for us. Once if you have this, merge two nodes with the smallest weight. Okay. So repeat this step two until only one tree is formed. Merge nodes with the smallest two smallest weights. So that need to be repeated several number of times so that finally we will get only one tree. Okay, so resulting tree is called as Huffman tree. So from the Huffman tree, we can get the Huffman code. Okay, so as an analysis part, what we have is we can compute something called as the average number of bits per symbol that is used. So this is computed as for A, the length is 2 and the frequency is 0.35. For B, the length is 3 and the frequency is 0.1. For C, the length is 2 and the frequency is 0.2. Similarly, for D, the length is 2 and the frequency is 0.2. The last one, underscore, the length is 3 and the frequency is 0.15. So if you multiply and add it, you will get 2.25. So this is what we say, that average number of bits per symbol. Suppose if you use fixed length coding, there are 5 characters. So you need a fixed length coding minimum of 3 bits. Minimum of 3 bits are required for fixed length coding. So since for fixed length coding, we need minimum 3 bits. And for this particular algorithm, the average bits are 2.25. The compression ratio is nothing but 25%. Okay. So this is what we can understand how well our variable length coding works. As a part of the exercise, you can work on these two problems. This problem is first problem is very similar to the one we have discussed, but you can see that frequencies are changed here. Frequencies are slightly changed. Okay. So once if it is done, you can encode this particular symbol. I also decode this. The second exercise that you can try is given this text, you need to encode with the Huffman coding. Please note here, frequencies are not given. Since the frequencies are not given, you are supposed to compute the frequencies. How to compute the frequencies? Look into this particular message. This message consists of 15 characters. How many times A is repeated? A is repeated one number of times. The frequency of A is 1 by 15. B is repeated 2 times. The frequency of B is 2 by 15. C is repeated 3 times. So frequency of C is 3 by 15. Similarly, E is repeated 5 times. 5 by 15 is the frequency. For D, 4 by 15 is the frequency. So frequency, you need to compute it. Then you have to construct the tree. So this is how for this particular problem, you can work it out. So that's all today's session.